News updates top headlines for tonight, Friday, August 4. Freedom of expression was stymied during past regime, says Minister Catherine Hughes. Minister Joseph Harmon says it's a little too late for them to go. MNCC to get financial aid from Communities Ministry to offset debts. And in court, homeless man remanded for break and enter and larceny. Good evening, I'm Ashley Scotland with the details of these and other stories live from MTV Studio. As the opposition and government continue to bicker on the Broadcasting Amendment Bill, Minister of Public Telecommunications Catherine Hughes alleges that freedom of expression was stymied under the past regime.
It was not a quiet day in the National Assembly when the debate between government and opposition continued on the Broadcasting Amendment Bill. Leading the government's charge on day two of the debate was Minister of Telecommunications, Cathy Hughes, who lambasted the opposition for making the claim that the bill will impede press freedom. Taking the opposition head-on, Minister Hughes alleged that there was an assault on freedom of expression during the past regime.
There is insufficient public service announcements in Guyana on the television, on radio. And this, in fact, is an opportunity for private broadcasters to produce such material themselves.
In disagreement, the opposition believes the bill contains strategic political objectives and draconian measures.
The Honorable Minister, or Prime Minister, also used two words, Mr. Speaker, which I believe I find rather contradictory, having regard to the nature of this bill that is before the House. He said that the bill is revolutionary and progressive. Mr. Speaker, this bill is counter-revolutionary. It's counter-revolutionary and anti-progressive.
The Broadcasting Amendment Bill, if passed without amendment, will see a number of new provisions. This is to avoid hate speech and terror threats, among others. Broadcasters will also be mandated to apply for licenses within 30 days, as all licenses will be revoked. The bill will also require broadcasters to allow 60 minutes of airtime for public service announcements between 6 and 22 hours daily. Meanwhile, broadcasters have been calling for an urgent meeting with the Prime Minister as they differ on some of the amendments in the bill. However, their calls went unanswered. Sandy Ramotar for MTV's News Update.
More news still ahead, do stay tuned. Tune into MTV for live ball-by-ball coverage of the Hero Caribbean Premier League 2020 tournament from August 4. Watch 7 countries, 6 teams, and 30 thrilling matches as each team competes for the winning title in Trinidad. Take this opportunity to maximize your business potential through affordable advertising and get a chance to win prizes and get free advertising spots. For more information on how you can secure these fast-selling advertising packages, kindly call our marketing department on 226-3593, 225-0569, or 622-0273. Don't miss this offer.
My house is the sum of my dreams, my work, and my dedication to my family. That's why I only use Argus cement.
In your projects, what matters most is what goes inside. Be sure they're built with the trust and quality that only Argus cement can deliver. Argus cement, green light for Guyana.
Yes, it's our biggest reduction sale on just for you. Celebrating our third anniversary this month at our Regent Street location. Check us out for our 2017 new designs and a wide selection of quality furniture readily available or made to order. Also, for your grocery, beverage, and stationery needs, check out our supermarket. We cater for that. And be sure to visit our hardware department as well. Prices are unbeatable. Shemakia Woodworking, Inc. Call us at 231-6020 or 276-3071.
John Lewis Styles proudly introduces Everest Bags, a complete and affordable line especially suited for back to school. Lunch bags from $3,500, backpacks from $4,500, pulley backpacks from $10,995. Also available are messenger bags, computer bags, waist pouches, duffel bags, gym bags, and even camping bags, all for the same price or less than buying online. And it's already here on Waterloo Street. John Lewis Styles, simply different.
In today's fast-paced world of modern finance, with its many options and opportunities, you will need good advice and help getting value for your money. Hand in Hand Trust is the way to go, from owning your own home or business. With our residential and commercial mortgages, we'll help you realize your dreams. You can also access investment deposit accounts, share brokerage services, personal trust, thrift and pension plan trusteeship, property management, investment portfolio management, safe deposit boxes, the convenience of our Cambio, Western Union, and Bill Express services. Hand in Hand Trust for financial services and more. Helping you get the most out of your financial resources and your life.
Minister of State Joseph Harmon disclosed that government will be constructing a special needs school at Schoonard on the west bank of Demerara.
Minister of State Joseph Harmon, during a post-cabinet press briefing, declared that cabinet has arrived at a decision to construct a special needs school at Schoonard on the west bank of Demerara.
Cabinet noted the award of contracts as follows for the construction of a special needs school at Schoonard on the west bank of Demerara, region number 3, the Minister of the Communities, in the sum of $27,974,000, a contract awarded to S&K Construction Services.
According to Minister Harmon, with the relevant data received regarding the percentage of children affected with some sort of disability, specifically in Region 3, government found it necessary to provide such an institution.
A survey had been carried out or conducted across Region 3, and it was discovered that there were many children with disabilities across the region who were in need of special skills training. It was therefore decided that the construction of a school to cater to such training was essential, and that is what the result of this contract.
Special needs refers to the context of children at school, particularly educational requirements resulting from learning difficulties, physical disability or emotional and behavioral difficulties. In Guyana, there are several special needs schools that cater for the educational needs of children. Reporting for MTV News Update, LaShawna Gomes, Curlinius.
Businessman Imran Khan says he and the Commissioner of Police, Silal Prasad, shared a close relationship for 12 years now. He claims that he usually provides the police with intelligence. Find out more in this report.
Now, due to 12 years of friendship you've had, Mr. Silal, you've always had his telephone number?
Yes, sir.
His cell number?
Yes, sir.
Do you have his home number?
No, sir.
His office number, per se? Did he ever give you an office number for him?
No, sir.
Could you give us an approximation or estimate as to how often you would use or call Mr. Sealer, if at all?
Well, sir, a frequent call, I would not say that much frequent. But I can't really recall exactly how frequent. I mean, 12 years. But I would maintain that we do talk on phones.
The calls on the phone, would that be initiated at all times by you? You're the first person at all times to make that call?
At times I would make calls, or at times he would return calls or make calls to me.
So it was 50-50 friendship?
Yes, sir.
Businessman Imran Khan testified that he knew Commissioner of Police Silal Prasad approximately 12 years now. He told the commission that during those years, the two would exchange phone calls and meet at different places.
Annually, and you would find between the year of individual years, the police usually have various activities, functions, that where some of the functions may be kept in the conference rooms where with senior officers and members of the publics. You would find that time to time, you would find that you have activities at other places. At certain times, you would find activities at the highway, which different areas, different times.
You were invited to those?
Yes, sir.
Who are the other kinds of persons, non-police officers, who might be involved at those events?
What I would say, sir, is member of the publics, but to recall individuals, but members of the civilians. But, oh, that's a civilian, sir. It's not officers alone.
He also told the commission that he usually provide intelligence to the Guyana Police Force.
We had ongoing, in terms of what I would say is that we had a few exchange in terms of information-wise, in terms of intelligence purpose. At times, you know, if you have like criminal elements in areas and those stuff, and you would try to get access to those things, I would be able to filter him with that information at time to time. And beside that, otherwise our friendship is mainly a bit communication, how you do all things, and we maintain that on cell phones. And
the businessman denied that he had knowledge about the alleged plot to assassinate President David Granger prior to March 29, 2017.
You have not been in any way accused of being engaged in the alleged plot to assassinate President David Granger. Is that correct? You have not been?
No, sir. I've never been accused for that, sir.
All right. So you could not have asked Commissioner Police Silal Prasad any assistance in that connection?
No, sir.
Thanks.
I never asked him for that.
Thank you, sir.
Assistance, sir.
He says on the night of March 29, when he arrived at the Criminal Investigation Department, he was met with death threats from Andrew Gillard. Khan alleged that when he was going to lodge a report at the CID, he was physically assaulted by two officers. He said his phone and gun was taken, but is unsure whether the gun was booked in the official entry list of the force.
While being there, the police had a rile push around with me in terms of taking this report, and they don't want to take this report, making a serious excuse and saying that this guy come from different places. And I continue to repeat myself, as I told you earlier, and I told him that I'm placed on 10,000 bail and I don't have that money to go on bail. And I then went on telling him that I have a medical and I have to see a doctor here, and I don't have the money and I'm already placed on bail. And we had a conversation in relation to the arrest, which I repeat myself, as I told you earlier, exactly what I say to you. And that is what I related to Mr. Silal in terms of the assault and the threats and arrested. I'm on the bench.
Nikhil John, the reporting for MTV News Update.
Demerara Tobacco Company Limited cries to have consultations on the recently passed tobacco bill is a little too late, says the Minister of State, Joseph Harmon. Find out more in this report.
These statements by interested groups coming after the National Assembly, we have had a full debate on the matter. I think basically it's a little bit too late for what they want to get done.
That was the Minister of State Joseph Harmon's response to queries raised by the Demerara Tobacco Company Limited, DemToco. Minister Harmon said the $4 billion in taxes from DemToco that government will place in jeopardy can be compared to the health of the citizens of the country. The minister affirmed that the government will not sacrifice the health of Guyanese for revenues.
We will not sacrifice the health of this nation, even for $4 billion, even if it meant $4 billion or $5 billion. The health of this nation is invaluable. There's no price that we can put to the lives of the citizens of this country.
However, in stark contrast, Demtoko said it would not be sensible for the government to press the pause button on the tobacco control bill and consider the far-reaching implications for its treasury. Harmon said if the company has other queries, the Ministry of Finance should be approached.
Whether in fact there is a point to be made, I believe this must be now a matter of consultation with the Ministry of Finance when they're looking at the budget and so on to see whether in fact any accommodation can be made. But as far as taking this law, I see somebody in the newspaper saying now the bill should go to select committee. We've passed that stage.
Giannis Abrams reporting for MTV's News Update.
Coming up, acting top cop has no personal vendetta against Silal Prasad and the crime chief COI hears, and a new fireboat to be acquired for the Guyana Fire Service.
BB, is we're going with so much Windex for clean windows, all them fancy curtains, it's not even Christmas.
Hi girl, mind your own business, I got big plans.
But BB,
your house don't even have windows.
Girl, you ain't think I know it ain't got window?
Yes, I know it ain't got window.
But look, Mokesh promised me that he carrying me down by the window factory when he come home at Eccles. It named Beeson. Like you ain't know nothing, girl. Right now, everybody talking about how Beeson got the strongest windows. Plus, they got a deal right now. If you buy 10 windows, you get a free bathroom window. So I could mind your business instead of you minding me own.
Beeson Windows and Doors, serving Guyana with the highest quality standard windows for your home, office, or commercial building.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Puran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
My house is the sum of my dreams, my work, and my dedication to my family. That's why I only use Argus cement.
In your projects, what matters most is what goes inside. Be sure they're built with the trust and quality that only Argus cement can deliver. Argus cement, green light for Guyana.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for a single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Acting Police Commissioner David Ramnarine, while being cross-examined by attorney Glenn Hanuman, says he has no personal vendetta against Silal Prasad and Wendell Blanham. Ramnarine told the commission he sees no need to hold a grudge against those two individuals, despite he was investigated. Find out more in this report.
Acting Commissioner of Police David Ramnarine was cross-examined by attorney Glenn Hanuman, who is representing Silal Prasad. Hanuman began to question Ramnarine's competence in investigations because he does not possess training in that field. The attorney then began to delve into the allegation of Ramnarine abusing his privilege while acting as the Commissioner of Police in 2016. Hanuman says that Commissioner of Police Silal Prasad had the cause to have the Office of Professional Responsibility investigate the matter.
So how did you feel about the commission doing those
things? I didn't feel bad about it.
The commissioner makes a complaint against you about how you used to use firearms. Then he prevent a proper investigation by denying access. Did you feel good about that?
Obviously, from a professional standpoint, it surprised me that here was my commissioner launching an investigation into some purported breach involving me, but at the same time, not interested, denying the investigator access to the records.
So
it surprised me.
So the feeling you had was surprised? You were
yes,
upset?
I was surprised.
You were not upset?
Maybe I was.
Maybe.
Between surprise and probably disappointment.
The reason you are trying to now castigate Commissioner Sidhar Prasad is because of that very feeling that you've got since last year about how we complained against you, how we denied your proper investigation. Is that same upset make you come and talk these things?
No.
Well, not only that. You also think it will help your chance of becoming Commissioner Prasad.
This is very shocking to me.
Sir,
this is very shocking to me.
Do you want
no.
to be the Commissioner of Police?
I'd like to.
You would like to. The reason you're saying you're bad talking, Mr. Posada, Mr. Ballum, is you're trying to say, well, I would have left no stone unturned, and I would investigate the President and so on. You're sucking up to the powers that be
no.
in order to try and become the Commissioner of Police.
No. I don't have to do that. I am a professional.
Yeah.
I believe in discharging my duties when I would have acted as commissioner in keeping with the Constitution, the law, and the Police Act.
Hello. When you didn't do any investigative exams, how many promotional exams did you do?
I've done 2 promotional exams.
Well, let me suggest to you that you are more interested in promotion than proper investigation. That's what you're more interested in.
I am interested in the conduct of a proper investigation.
Tell me what you did when you were acting as commissioner to ensure that this investigation is properly conducted.
I gave instructions to the crime chief, who is charged under, I think it's Standing Order 64 or 62, with the investigations of crime. On that very morning when he reported it to me.
You didn't have to give those instructions. He was already investigating. Not so?
No. This was too important a matter which involved the head of state and could not have been left without me emphasizing to the crime chief such importance.
Inspector Prem Narayan was also recalled to be cross-examined after he testified before the commission. Inspector Narayan says he did not take notes from the conversation he had with the top cop on March 29, 2017. He explained that soon after the call ended, he reported to the head of the Major Crimes Unit, Mitchell Caesar.
The reason you may want to mislead this tribunal is because you don't want to take responsibility for giving bail to a man alleged to it, but you want to put that responsibility to someone else. You realize it would be political suicide for you to take responsibility for that bail decision.
I don't regard that decision as any political, anything to do with politics.
I'm thinking it might affect your promotion. If you say you made a decision to give bail to a man alleged who wanted to kill the president, you know it would affect your promotion.
Whatever decision I make, I am a professional and I stand with my decisions. I don't make it because of political interference. I'm a policeman.
Right. As a result, politically correct things right now.
As a result, no sir. As a result, I never lied to this commission and I don't intend to do so.
Let's go a little different to it. Whenever you report it to Caesar or whenever you report it to this commission, you did not report the exact words that were used by Caesar, by Mr. Posati. What you did was preceded or interpreted it. You didn't use the exact words. You were not quoting.
What I can tell you is that I reported to Caesar and this commission words to the effect, meaning the same thing that the commissioner meant when he spoke to me.
Words to the effect?
Yes, sir. And meaning with the same meaning. He did not say the word, I'm instructing you. And for my 17 years as a police officer, I've never had any of my seniors say, I am instructing you. They would basically tell me what they want me to do. Being a discipline rank and being in a discipline organization, they don't have to tell me that they're instructing me. I understand the instruction once they speak.
Yeah, so it is your evidence that Silal Prasad never told you I am instructing you to do that. That is
yes, sir. I would agree with that.
Now, do you therefore agree that whatever it was, whatever were the exact words that Mr. Prasad used to you, you took them to be an instruction? Would that be fair?
The words that he used to me amounted to an instruction.
Yes.
Being a member of the disciplinary force, where a standing. That is what I understand it to be.
Yes.
There is a standing order that governs the Guyana Police Force, and I can't recall seeing the word suggestion in it, sir.
The commission was adjourned until Wednesday, August 9, 2017. Corporal German Laundrie is expected to be recalled and cross examined based on his testimony to the commission. In addition, Luana Walker, who gave investigators a statement which was read before the commission, is also expected to testify on Wednesday, August 9. Nikhil John, the reporting for MTV News Update.
Government will soon be acquiring a new fireboat for the purpose of carrying a large amount of water to locations where there is fire, as well as for search and rescue missions.
Minister of State Joseph Harmon declared that government will soon acquire a multi-purpose fire rescue boat for the Guyana Fire Service. The minister noted it has been decades since the fire service had a fire rescue boat.
It should be noted that the last fire boat that we had here in Guyana, the Forbes B, was put out of service in 1978 after the destruction by fire of the Guyana Rice Board Wharf that was suspected to be an act of arson. Since then, there have been several unsuccessful attempts to acquire a new vessel.
Minister Harmon said one of the main reasons the fireboat is necessary is to ensure the safety of businesses on or near the country's wharves.
It should be noted that the port of Georgetown, for 10 miles inland from the mouth of the Demerara River, is the center of commercial activities, including the storage of petroleum products and the import and export of food and industrial supplies, all of which are vulnerable to the ravages of fire. The vessel is also designed to carry out search and rescue missions and marine medical evacuation in our rivers and along the coastline.
Reporting for MTV News Update, LaShawna Gomes, Cornelius.
More news still ahead. Stay with us.
My thoughts, well, for me, internet has changed the world, and Blaze has changed the internet here in Guyana one more time. I mean, long are the days where you have to wait for your favorite TV show to be on at 8 o'clock on a Friday or a Saturday night. This day and age, it's about downloading it, streaming it, and watching it at your convenience. And Blaze for us gives us the opportunity now to watch our favorite shows from England, from America, Caribbean, you know, when we want it, how we want it.
My house is the sum of my dreams, my work, and my dedication to my family. That's why I only use Argus cement.
In your projects, what matters most is what goes inside. Be sure they're built with the trust and quality that only Argus cement can deliver. Argus cement, green light for Guyana.
Stay with us and enjoy comfort away from home. Palm Spring International Hotel, 2022 3rd Avenue, Bartica Region 7. For the most luxurious presidential master and family suite, Dublin single rooms with all modern conveniences such as air conditioning, cable television, refrigerator, hot and cold bath, jacuzzi, free Wi-Fi and access to pool, 24-hour security and complimentary breakfast. Enjoy fine dining at our restaurant and special meals prepared freshly by our chef. Remember to visit our bar and try our tasty cutters. Karaoke every Thursday. Visit us today or call our friendly staff on 455-0063, 629-0356 or 679-7870 for more information or to make a reservation. Be on your dreams within your reach. Palm Spring International Hotel.
GBTI Quality Lifestyle Personal Loan Plan offers you flexible options to take care of your needs. Whether it's improving your home, furthering your education, vacation, or medical expenses, GBTI can help you. Apply now. GBTI.
You're still with News Update. Welcome back. As the main city council currently has $1 billion in debt to the Guyana Power and Light Company, the Minister of State, Joseph Harmon, said that the Ministry of Communities will assist the council financially if the need arises.
After the town clerk of Georgetown, Royston King, disclosed that the Mayor City Council owes the Guyana Power and Light Company over $1 billion, the Minister of State said that slow payments is always an issue for the council. Harmon noted that the council has always found ways to pay its debts.
Where they are unable to do so, the Ministry of the Communities had actually stepped in and given assistance. And I believe that mechanism is one which we will continue to use.
The minister mentioned that the council has its responsibilities, and if they are not able to fulfill their duties, they would normally ask the Ministry of Communities to solve the issues as soon as possible.
So I'm not sure exactly whether they've actually asked for help by the Ministry of the Communities as yet. But what I'm saying to you is that as a government, because this is the capital city and we're so concerned about the health of the nation, we're so concerned about the environment, that we would want to see that the matter is dealt with as quickly as possible.
However, when the council had requested $600,000 from the Ministry of Communities to pay staff for December 2016, it was not granted. Yanis Abrams reporting for MTV's News Update.
Here is what went down in the Georgetown Magistrates Court on Friday, August 4. A homeless man was this morning remanded to prison on a simple larceny charge after he made an appearance before Senior Magistrate Leroy Daly in the Georgetown Magistrates Courts. Robert Beige North, 49, pleaded not guilty to the charge which alleged that between August 2 and 3 at Foreshaw Street, Queenstown, Georgetown, he broke into Nehemiah Comprehensive School and stole 2 electrical fans, 10 small bottles of water and 2 stabilizers, all totaling $42,100. Beige North told the court that he was walking on the road and picked up a fan from a garbage heap. The unrepresented man was remanded to prison until August 18. According to the prosecutor, 2 of the fans were found in the defendant's possession. He said that the items recovered were positively identified by the head teacher as the property of the school. The Guyana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 7:32. Let's turn our attention to the Demerara Harbor Bridge schedule. That sums up our newscast for tonight, but before we go, here's a recap of our major headlines. Freedom of expression was stymied during past regime, says Minister Catherine Hughes. Minister Joseph Harmon says it's a little too late for Dem Toko. MNCC to get financial aid from Communities Ministry to offset debts. And in court, homeless man remanded for break and enter and larceny. The newscast can be viewed online on MTV's Facebook page and also on our YouTube channel. The news will be rebroadcasted later tonight at 23 hours and at 6:30 on Saturday, August 5. On behalf of our news team, I'm Ashley Scotland, thanking you for watching. Good night.